And I was trying so hard not to spill anything. I guess that's what happens, right? So you might be wondering why? What's the point? What's the point of having this fish tank, taking the time to gather all these fruits and the lights? Well, it obviously has something to do with photography or video, but this is not a paid gig. I'm not getting paid by anyone in particular to do this. I'm doing this on my own free time and I plan to make money with it. And what makes that possible is the world of stock footage. And stock footage has been out forever. It's just modern day marketing and social media especially, and even movies, when they don't have a clip that they need, they'll often refer to stock footage. It's easier and more cost efficient to them to buy the clip outright from a place like Shutterstock or Adobe Stock, or any of the other ones out there, than hiring a production crew to go shoot. That's what's great about stock footage. If you're a contributor, not only can you create stuff like this on your own time, but you don't know who's gonna buy it. Anyone could buy it. And these stock sites have their own pricing, and certain formats sell for more, like 4K versus 1080p. It's commercial use. The one thing that makes stock footage so awesome for contributors and creators is these big platforms often have a non-exclusive deal with their contributors. And that means I can upload one clip to all these different stock sites that have their own user bases and customers. Basically putting your feelers out there, and you want everybody to see it. And that's, you know, that's the cool part about non-exclusive stock footage. I'm gonna shoot some fruit falling in this tub behind me. I'm gonna capture it in slow motion. The 1DX does a good job in slow motion, but when it comes to falling objects, it's just not slow enough. So I kind of have to take what I can get with it. But the best way to learn is repetition, right? Whenever I start a new type of project that I have no experience in yet, I'm always expecting some kind of failure. I'm always expecting to either have forgotten something, the shoot not go as planned, or just a technical issue that I would in turn learn the next time I practiced it. That's kind of what this is. I've already done this once, and I thought I was on the right track, but I realized my aperture was too wide open, which means my depth of field was just too narrow. And I shot it, I think it was like 2.5, which is super narrow. And I just thought that would look cool. I knew that it would give me like this much depth of field, but I probably should have shot like, you know, 6.3 or F9 or something to make sure I get most of what I want in focus. So I'm gonna retry this. I feel a little better this time about it all. And after we shoot a couple stock videos, we'll talk a little bit about Black Box. And without spoiling it too much, Black Box is just a platform that helps distribute your footage. So what is Black Box and how can it help you, and how has it helped me? Well, simply put, Black Box is a platform for creators who shoot stock video to post their clips, which in turn Black Box submits them to the four major agencies who will sell your stock footage for you. These agencies being Adobe Stock, Shutterstock, Pond5, and Videoblox. I'm sure there's going to be more in the future. Not only will they distribute it for you, but the platform also allows you to collaborate with other people very easily. Be it a model, a curator, an editor, or anyone else who's pretty much a part of your projects. And the way that works is you take the overall revenue stream and you divide it up between the other collaborators who assisted on that project. And anytime that clip sells,
everyone automatically gets paid out through Black Box. So in other words, it eliminates the hassle of being the one responsible to collect the revenue and then distribute it out manually if you did collaborate with other people. It's also a lot easier to collaborate with people and present the idea to them when there's already an established platform for this. All you have to do is explain to them how it works and how to sign up. And then they sign up, fill out their profile information, and you easily link to their account. And that's that. Now it's a true collaboration, and the other people involved will start to earn that recurring revenue based on the sales of that clip for the lifetime of that clip. And that's the amazing part about this platform. Now, when you upload your clip or clips, you will be asked to fill out your meta description and your keywords. And then after that, of course, you need your model release forms, and there's a spot to upload that, or your property release forms, and then the ability to list other people as collaborators on this clip or batch of clips. And after that, you are good. Now, if you're new to stock footage and you've never experienced uploading to these main sites like Pond5 and Shutterstock and Adobe Stock and VideoBlocks and any other ones out there, if you don't have experience doing this one by one, you might not understand the complexity and the dynamics that these accounts ask for when uploading your clips. And that for me was enough to back away from doing stock footage, not because I didn't want to, but the curation process to fulfill the requirements for all these different accounts, plus uploading the same clip 4 or 5 different times, it becomes draining and it starts to become a little impractical for how much time you put into it. But if you've been doing this for years and you're just used to it, maybe you have somebody else doing it for you, you've grown through that. And I am sure if you are on Black Box and you're one of those people who have had this experience, I can assume Black Box is probably one of the best things you've ever come across in a really long time. But for those who have never gone through that process, believe me, it is a pain. For example, I remember uploading to Pond5 and they would ask for your camera make, the camera model, the location, and just so much information. And it's a lot of stuff to do. And then of course you have to categorize it, and all these different sites and platforms have different ways to categorize information. And it's just so much easier to do it one time and submit it and let Black Box do the rest. So not only are you getting the benefit of ease of uploading and distributing your clips, but you're also getting the benefit of easily collaborating with other people. Now, outside of the actual Black Box platform where you submit your clips, you assign contributors, and you fill out your meta descriptions or curate your clips, is the support. If you want to know something about a company that you couldn't find an answer for maybe on the website or anywhere else, support is extremely important, and we all know that. So that's why I want to just mention that the Black Box Facebook group is such an incredible place to be, because you get answers quick, you talk with other alike contributors, and you actually make pretty good friendships. I've met quite a few people through the Facebook group already, and it's been a really good experience, you know, and they're all doing the same thing you are. So questions and concerns, if you want advice, if you want anything, if you want to know anything about maybe composition, if you think this will sell, some criticism, or if you're looking for curators, then that is a place to be. Now, probably the biggest thing that all of us Black Boxers know is Pat McGowan's involvement. And I've never seen a CEO be as involved as they are as this man is. Props to him. He's got a very respectable philosophy that creators are behind pretty much everything, and he wants to keep Black Box that way, and he's always just as involved as other people are. It's the best place to be. Now, Black Box will be opening hubs soon, and Pat and I are actually working together to open this space up to become a contributor hub. Now, granted, this is my space, this is my office, and this is where I've worked for a few years now, but one day I had a question. I found some information about hubs springing up in your area on the Black Box website. So I just screenshotted that, put it in the group, and he responded. Then we ended up talking and decided to make this available. So that's just about it, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you're new to stock footage, then all of this is probably new to you. So I hope that first half of this video, with just that those little pointers about shooting and learning for the next time and stuff like that, I really hope that helps you in any way. Regardless, let me know if you have any questions. I'm always active in my comments and messages, so feel free to reach out. You can contact me through Instagram, that link's right below, and same with my referral link to Black Box, which is also below. That's just about it, guys. Thank you all for watching. I hope you have an awesome day, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.